Professor Dave again, let's talk about slopes and intercepts.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In math, when we use the word slope, it doesn't mean we are going to hit the slopes, although there is some similarity between the downward slope of a mountain and the meaning of this word in math. It means a line's rate of change in the vertical direction, which can be shallow or steep, just like a mountain. To understand how the slope of a line relates to the equation of the line, let's introduce a common form for linear equations, y equals mx plus b. We already know about x and y. These are the independent variable and dependent variable, respectively. But these other two terms represent characteristics of the line. M represents the slope of the line, which is, as we said, essentially how steep the line is, and B represents the y-intercept, which is the y-coordinate for the point where the line crosses the y-axis. Let's start by looking at the simplest example possible, y equals x. We already learned how to plot this line, so here it is, with every point showing an ordered pair where the x and y values are equivalent. To calculate the slope, we must understand that this is equal to rise over run, which means change in y over change in x. We can pick any two points on this line, and with these points, we take the difference in their y values and divide by the difference in their x values. Y is up and down, or the rise, and x is side to side, or the run. Rise over run. Let's pick these two points, 2, 2, and 4, 4. Rise over run can be represented this way, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, so we just plug the coordinates in. y2 is 4, y1 is 2, x2 is 4, and x1 is 2. We simplify and get 2 over 2, or 1. The slope of this line is 1. That should make sense, because y equals x is in y equals mx plus b form. It's just that m is 1 and b is 0. 1x is just x, and b is 0 because the line crosses the y-axis when y equals 0. So we get this very simple equation, y equals x. If a line has a slope that is greater than 1, it will tilt upwards like this, steeper and steeper, climbing towards infinity until it reaches complete verticality, at which point the slope is undefined because the line rises all the way to infinity in the y direction without any run at all, and infinity over 0 is undefined. If instead the slope is less than 1, the line tilts downwards this way, the slope getting smaller and smaller, until it is completely horizontal, at which point the slope will become 0. The line runs all the way to infinity in the x direction without rising at all, and 0 over infinity is 0. So vertical lines have an undefined slope, horizontal lines have 0 slope, and everything in between has some slope between 0 and infinity. If we continue past the horizontal, the slope becomes increasingly negative because as we run in the positive direction, the rise is negative or moving downwards. The slope will increase in the negative direction, approaching negative infinity until vertical, where the slope becomes undefined. Let's just quickly mention that any two points define a line. You could draw any two points at random on the coordinate plane, and there is a line that connects them. However, all lines contain an infinite number of points, since the coordinates can become infinitely precise, and any point on the line represents an x and y value that qualifies as a solution to the equation. We could pick two points, like 3, 2, and 5, 7, and draw a line between them. We could also calculate the slope. 7 minus 2 is 5, and 5 minus 3 is 2, so the slope is 5 halves. Always remember that when calculating slope, it doesn't matter which point is point 1 and which is point 2, but the coordinates of each point must remain together, So whichever y value is y2, the x value in that point must be x2 and not x1. That would lead to an incorrect slope calculation. Also, one point and a slope can define a line. We could say that a line passes through 2, 4 and has a slope of 3 halves. To draw this line, we would just go to the point 2, 4 and start applying the slope. Up 3 over 2. This could also be down 3, 2 to the left, because negative 3 over negative 2 also equals 3 halves. And that's how the slope, which we can regard as the rate of change, makes sense regardless of which direction you travel. Now that we understand slopes and y-intercepts, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.